Hello everyone, welcome to the next class on the probability and statistics. Today we will discuss about the next distribution called as the gamma distribution, and we will see how we can define the gamma distribution and with the help of the numerical examples. Myself Dr. Garg, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. You can follow this link where you can find the various distribution functions as well as the probability and stat videos. So first of all, before starting the gamma distribution, we must need that how this function will introduce and what is the role of this gamma function into the probability and statistics. So firstly, we will define the gamma function, which is a very important function, and it play many application in the different kinds of the probability and statistics. What is the gamma function? All of you know that this is the improper integral. This is from 0 to infinity x raised to power alpha minus 1 of ex. So look at that, this is the gamma function of n. So if I say e of this, and then what is the meaning of that? This is the gamma function of, look at that, this is alpha minus 1, here is alpha. So it is, if it is 2, then it is a 3. That is nothing but the sum of this. Based on this function, what are the several properties which are associated with this gamma function? The number one is, for any of the alpha which is greater than of the 1, we can define the value as gamma of alpha is nothing but alpha minus 1 times gamma of alpha minus 1, which you can easily obtain with the help of, if you integrate this by parts, you can take as a first function, second, and solve, you can solve this one. On the other hand, if I say, if for any positive integers, if here alpha is any of the real number is there, if my positive integer is there, then gamma function is nothing but my factorial, n minus 1 factorial. So it means, what is the gamma function of 3? This is 2 factorial, that is 2. So it means, if I say, what is the integration of this? So there is no need to solve them. If it is 0 to infinity, it is nothing but gamma function of 3. Now it's a 2. Similarly, what is the gamma function of 7? This is nothing but 6 factorial. So if I say this is my 5, what is that? This is nothing but my gamma function of 6. It means this is my 5 factorial. So 5 factorial, all of you know that this is 120, and so on. So this is a way you can solve them. And the third important property is, gamma function of the half is nothing but my root of pi. Based on this gamma function, we can define the probability. What will happen if I just take this function, if I just divided both sides by a gamma function of alpha, what is the meaning of that? This is a 1 over the domain of this. It means, in terms of the probability, what you get, that any of the function whose integration of the domain is 1, then that function is called as the PDF. So we can define this function as a gamma function. So we will see. And the graph of the gamma function of the positive x-axis of the alpha, gamma function of the alpha is like here. You can see, what is the gamma function of 1 is? This 1 is a real number, integer, so it's a 0 factorial is 1. So you can see, this is 1, 1, and so on. Now, how you can define the distribution function? So, first of all, this is the distribution function, because you can see that integration over the domain x to 0 to infinity, e raised to power minus x of this divided by here. So you can easily see that if I take outside of this, what is the integration of the numerator side? This is nothing but gamma function of alpha. So what is that? This is a 1. So it means this is a valid PMF. And this is of the first kind. It is called as the standard gamma distribution. And the only unknown parameter here is alpha. On the other hand, the second kind of the distribution function, which is related to the gamma, is here. You can easily see that there are the two parameters. Alpha is called as the shape parameters, while beta is called as the scale parameter. Why we call as the shape and scale, we will see. If you closely look about, it is also called as the two parameters gamma distribution. So if you find some books, you can find here two parameter gamma distribution. So you can easily clearly see that if beta is my 1, in this case it becomes here. So therefore, when beta is 1, then this gamma function becomes a standard distribution function, or standard gamma distribution function. So if you closely look about the graph of this, you can see that if I just fix the value of beta as a 1, it means I just want to draw the graph of this. What will happen if my alpha is 1? So 1 minus 1 is 0. So x raised to power 0 is 1. So what will happen if alpha is 1? This function is nothing but e raised to power minus x. So you can see the graph of this red line corresponding alpha 1, and so on. So since it will represents about the shape of the function, you can see this is the shape, this is the blue color shape and so on. So that's why this alpha is called as the shape parameter. And you can see this beta is nothing but the scale parameter. Why? You can see that in this case, if I use, look at the red color and the green color. So the shape of the red color is a very high, max value is very high as compared to the lower value. So this is the graph of the two parameters. In order to elaborate more, you can see if I just fix the value of beta firstly, you can see alpha, and if I increase the value of alpha, so you can see here. On the other hand, if I fix the value of the gamma alpha, you can analyze the impact of the scale. You can see there is a blue and pink color. So this is the blue color and this is my pink color is there. And whenever you increase the value of scale parameter, you can see this peak is high and so on. So that's why this is the scale and the shape parameters. Also, you can clearly see that from the distribution function, if you set alpha is 1 and beta is lambda, then this gamma distribution that is here, e x raised to power alpha minus 1 of this, you can see what will happen. So if I take beta is my lambda, so this is lambda raised to power 1, 1 minus 1 0, e raised to power minus of this, gamma function of 1 is 1. So which distribution is there? This is nothing but my exponential distribution. So it means exponential distribution is a special case of the gamma distribution. Also, there are several other distributions like Erlang distribution, Kaiser distribution, all are the special case of the gamma distribution. As we have seen, exponential distribution, if we set alpha is 1 and beta is lambda, then it's exponential. On the other hand, if I say in this case, alpha is my real number, it is a greater than 0, it can be of the real number. But if I set alpha as a positive integer number, then this gamma distribution becomes the Erlang distribution. Also, if I replace this denominator part to be the 2 raised power alpha of this, then this becomes the chi-square distribution. So all of you remember that chi-square distribution is nothing but my here if you replace it. So it means the gamma distribution play a very important role. What is the CDF? All of you know that we have discussed several times in a previous video how you can define the CDF is. It is denoted by capital X and here. So how you solve them? This is nothing but my integration of the lower limit of this is minus infinity. So minus infinity to x of here. So if I just consider the first kind of the PDF. So if I substitute the value here, you will get this as the PDF. So once you know the value of the x, you can easily solve them. For example, if I just want to calculate x less than of 2, what is the meaning of that? This is I just want to calculate f of 2. It means I simply take the integration of here. So whatever the value of the alpha is given to you, you can solve them, you will get the required answer. We will see them in the next couple of examples. Say this is the one particular example. The daily consumption of the milk is in the excess of the 20,000. So if I consider x as my milk capacity, so it means x will be definitely of the greater than of the 20,000. This is given to you. Is approximately distributed as the gamma distribution, with the scale parameter as 1 by 10,000 and the shape parameter is 2. The daily capacity is my 30,000 and what is the probability that it is insufficient? So it's very simple. If you remember this, if you browse the exponential distribution, the link is given in the description. The same example we have considered here, but instead of exponential, we consider here as gamma distribution. So look at that. If I consider x is my daily consumption, so what is the meaning of that? X is my excess of this. So it means x will be my greater than 20,000. So if I take y as x minus 20,000 and this distribution becomes the gamma distribution. So if I consider y, then y becomes a gamma distribution and the PDF is here. So look at that. This is my PDF of the, there is a two kind PDF, two parameter distribution function. Beta is my 1 by 10,000 of alpha, alpha is my 2, gamma function of alpha, y raised power 2 minus 1 and so on. Now once you will get this PDF, what do you want to calculate? The probability will be insufficient. When the stock will be insufficient? When the someone will demand more than of the 30,000, then only we have the insufficient capacity. Because the city has already a 30,000 in their stock. So when it will be the insufficient? When it is more than of the 30,000. So it means my target is to find here. But my PDF is given in the y. So how you can convert this y? We can calculate the value of x from here. This is y plus 20,000 is greater than of the 30,000. So from here, can you calculate the value of y? This is nothing but my 10,000. So this is here. So since this is there, so how you calculate this one? This is from 10,000 to infinity of f of y of dy. So after substituting this fy here, we can calculate like this. How you integrate them? So that's very simple. If I substitute y by 10,000 as my z, so what is my dy upon 10,000? This is nothing but dz. So it means one, what is that? I can write this as this into e raised to power of this. So this is a square, so one I can take as here over this. Okay, so what will happen? This is now my y, this is now my z, this is my minus of z, and this is my d of z. So substitute here. So look at the limit. What will happen if y, when y is my 10,000, so what is the value of z? Is 1. When y is my infinity, z becomes my infinity. So that's 1 to infinity. Now you can easily integrate them, so you will get as the required answer. So remember that here in this particular example, alpha is my 2, so that's why the integration is very easy. So look at that. If now alpha minus 1 is here, but what will happen if my if alpha is not be a 2, then it's not an easy task to solve them. So then how you can solve them? You can use the gamma integration table, which is easily available in any of the standard normal or standard probability and stat book, and this is the look like a table is there. So once you can write in terms of the gamma function, you can write directly the value of here. For example, if you want to write the value of here, so how you check that? This is a 1, this is 0.4. So the answer of this one will be 0.97844. So this is the way you can simply use them. You can browse this from the any of the standard gamma function or probability book. Now what is the relation between the normal distribution and gamma distribution? What is the meaning of that? I just want to find what is the relation between normal and gamma. Means if x follows the normal distribution, then is that z square by 2 follow the gamma distribution? What is the meaning of the z? Is z is nothing but x minus mu by sigma is a standard normal distribution. So this is the result. We will see how we can prove that. So look at that. If x follows the normal distribution, this means if x follows the normal distribution, then the u, find the PDF of this u. So this is nothing but the z square. So what is given to you? X follow the normal distribution, which implies that z follows the normal distribution, standard normal distribution. What is the meaning of the n? Is this is the standard normal variate. So once you know the it's a standard normal variate, so what is the PDF of the z? So all of you know that what is the mean of the z? Is mean of z is my 0. What is the variance of z? Is my 1. So the PDF is here. Now what is that? You want to find the relation PDF of u, which is given to be here. So remember that what is the technique? Is that if I say instead of the z square by 2, what is the PDF of this? Instead of u is z square by 2, someone can ask you find the PDF of z plus 1. Someone can ask you find the z cube. Someone can ask you find the PDF of u is sine of z. So what you can do is, the simple procedure is, how you can find the PDF of the u is, I call as g as the PDF, f of z of dz by du. So this is the rule. You can find the PDF of even z square by 2. You can find the PDF of this. You can find the PDF of z square plus 1. You can find the PDF of this, and so on, any of them. So first of all, you have to find the dz by du. So since u is given to you z square by 2, we can find the value of z from here. What is the value of z? Is plus minus of 2. So from here, can you find? I can write this again as root of 2 at here. So what is the value of the dz by du? So this is plus minus of this, 1 by 2 of this. So this root 2 and this 2 will be cancelled out. So this will be here. So therefore, it means it's a plus minus. So you have to take one as a plus, second as a minus. So substitute this value here. What is the f of z? Is here. So you can substitute z value also in here. So it means f of this. So this value becomes my f of plus minus of this. So you can substitute value here. Now you can see that f of z is an even function. So once it's an even function, so you can, you know that integration of the even function is nothing but the twice. So I have taken as a twice of that. So now this is a simple, this is a root, two root it will be cancel out. So what is the rest of that? So can you think about that? This is the gamma function. Yes, this is the gamma function. I can write this here. So you can see this is nothing but my PDF of the gamma function. Look at that. What is the gamma function is? X raised power alpha minus 1 e raised power minus x upon gamma function of alpha. So you can see if you compare them, x is nothing but my u, alpha is nothing but my half. So it means this is my gamma function. So this is a gamma distribution with a scale parameter alpha is half. So therefore u follows a gamma distribution of half, that is here. So you can see u, that is a z square by 2, follows a gamma distribution of this. So this is the way you can find the new distribution once you know the here. So therefore we conclude that if x follows the normal distribution, then z square by 2, or you can see here, this is a z square. This follows the gamma distribution with parameter alpha is half. So this is a simple quiet proof is there. Also, some, if you want to calculate the mean and variance movement generating function, this will be there. But we will try to solve this. That will be see in our next class, that how we can find the mean and variance of the gamma distribution. Till then, you can simply browse this link for finding the various distribution function and probability videos. Till then, best of luck students, happy learning.